Keto diet and force per unit area. One-third of Yank adults suffer from high force per unit area. It's a heavy ill health that may result in heart attacks and strokes. Obviously, the upper the force per unit area, the greater the danger. Aging and obesity greatly increase the possibilities of developing high force per unit area. Blood pressure is typically treated with a range of medicines, a number of which may have side effects. The most effective force per unit area is 120/80. High force per unit area is that the results of hypertension, and therefore the causes aren't always clear, but we board an increasingly tense world, and more people are handling high force per unit area. It is a known proven fact that people laid low with high force per unit area frequently carry excess belly fat and may become in danger for type 2 diabetes. To induce at the foundation of these problems may require a change in lifestyle. The symptoms of high force per unit area will be caused by an overload of carbohydrates within the diet, quite the body is ready to handle. As we've discussed, carbohydrates are converted into sugars, which raise the body's glucose level, forcing the body to make additional insulin. Insulin stores fat, and more than insulin can result in obesity. All of this will have a negative effect on your force per unit area. Consuming fewer carbohydrates decreases both the amount of insulin and therefore the force per unit area level. This straightforward dietary change can make an enormous difference in your force per unit area. In a remarkable study released within the Archives of Medical Specialty, 146 overweight people took part during a weight loss experiment. The people were divided into two groups. One group was placed on a ketogenic diet containing a maximum of 20 grams of carbohydrates, while the opposite group was given the weight loss drug orlistat, additionally to being counseled to follow a low-fat regimen. Both groups showed similar weight loss. What surprised the researchers was that one-half the keto group showed a decrease in force per unit area, while only 21% of the diet group had any decrease in force per unit area. While weight loss itself would bring forth a lowering of blood pressure, the study suggests that a decrease in carbohydrate intake can help lower force per unit area even more. It was found that potassium specifically had an enormous effect on lower hypertension. Doctors recommend a minimum of 4,700 mg of potassium day by day for anyone wishing to lower his or her force per unit area. Foods high in potassium are avocado, acorn, squash, bananas, coconut water, dried apricots, pomegranate, salmon, spinach, sweet potato, white beans. While of these foods are permitted on the ketogenic diet, limit your intake of sweet potato and beans, which are starchy and may contain a high level of carbs. What do I eat a keto diet? Some people associate the keto diet with the bad word, fat, and are quick to dismiss it. Nothing may be farther from the reality. Fat is allowed, because it's converted into energy. Our body needs healthy fats to thrive. Other foods on the diet couldn't be healthier. When you're eating ketogenic, you're filling your body with nutrition. Let's take a glance at the foods you'll be eating. As this notes has already noted, the elimination of processed foods and sugar is one in every of the most effective stuff you can do for your health normally. Processed foods are crammed with toxic preservatives that do nothing for you but rob you of your physiological state. Fresh is usually better. When purchasing anything at the market, get into the habit of reading labels. They will be very sneaky and revealing. Keep your carbohydrates under 50 grams daily, and you'll feel the difference. A stricter ketogenic diet will contain approximately 20 grams of carbs daily. Food to eat a ketogenic diet. 1. Seafood. Everyone knows about the healthy fatty acids, vitamins and minerals in seafood. Only a few folks eat enough. The keto diet encourages the consumption of all things from the ocean. Shrimp and crabs are carb-free, and other shellfish contain only an occasional amount of carbohydrates. Fatty fish, like salmon and sardines, are highly recommended due to their high omega fatty acid content. Fish truly is brain food. Enjoy a minimum of 2 servings or more of seafood per week on the keto diet. Simple canned tuna counts as seafood. 2. Vegetables. Can a diet that recommends unlimited green, leafy vegetables be anything but healthy? They're extremely low in carbohydrates and bursting with vitamins, antioxidants, and therefore the fiber we'd like daily. Green vegetables like broccoli, spinach, and kale are believed to decrease the danger of heart diseases and cancer. Cauliflower and turnips will be prepared to appear and taste like rice or mashed potatoes, with much less starch and carbohydrates. Starchy vegetables, like potatoes or beets, do have carbs and may be limited on the keto diet. 3. Dairy foods. There are cheeses to satisfy everyone's taste. They're high in fat content for energy, high in protein and calcium, and low in carbohydrates. B. Yogurt and farmer's cheese are a good source of protein and calcium. They're low carb and fit well into the ketogenic lifestyle. Make sure to stay with plain yogurt, because the flavored types contain lots of sugar, as are the so-called low-fat versions of yogurt. You'll flavor yogurt and farmer's cheese yourself with some berries and nuts. 4. Avocados. Avocados are truly superfood. They're high in important vitamins and minerals, including potassium. In step with a study, avocados also are believed to assist lower cholesterol by 22%. Loaded with nutrients and delicious taste, avocados only have 2 grams of net carbohydrates. Use them in salads and sandwiches. 5. Meat and poultry. The keto diet lets you eat plenty of meat. Meat contains very few carbs and is high in protein to help you build muscles. Whenever possible, choose healthy, grass-fed meats, which are higher in fatty acids. 6. Eggs. Eggs are high in protein and contain a mere 1 gram of carbohydrates. As they are also inexpensive, they are ideal for anyone on a ketogenic diet. Eggs also make you feel full, thereby helping you eat less. Many people take pride in only consuming the whites of eggs, but the true nutrition lies in the yolk, so be sure to eat the egg in its entirety. 7. Coconut oil. Too many people are unfamiliar with coconut oil, another superfood. It is perfect for people dealing with diabetes and has been used with Alzheimer's patients. Coconut oil can be used in most recipes in place of butter or oil. You can also use it for frying and sautéing. 8. Dark chocolate. Did you know that dark chocolate has a high amount of antioxidants? As a matter of fact, dark chocolate is reaching superfood status. Chocolate with 80% or higher real cocoa powder can lower your blood pressure. An ounce of 80% dark chocolate contains 10 grams of carbohydrates, so it definitely counts as a healthy snack. Keep in mind, the lower of cocoa content, the less healthy the chocolate will be. Milk chocolate does not count as a healthy chocolate. Foods to avoid on a ketogenic diet. The keto diet has a lot less restricted foods than many other diets. Sugar, of course, should be avoided. That doesn't mean you can't enjoy sweet desserts. There are many keto-friendly recipes that substitute unsweetened applesauce for sugar in baked goods. Substitute sweeteners such as stevia can also be used in moderation. Keep in mind that fruits are healthful, but they do contain a great deal of sugar, so limit the amount you eat to just a few slices a day. Fruit juices are concentrates that have vitamins but lack fiber. And their sugar content is extremely high. Read the label on any bottle of juice before buying. The best juices are green, with just a hint of fruit for flavoring. Be careful with cereals. Most are packed with sugar and robbed of any nutrients. Many claim nutrition added, but all that means is that all nutrition has been removed and replaced with a small amount, and a whole lot of sugar for taste. 100% bran cereal will fit into your keto diet, and you can sweeten it with a handful of berries. Just be sure to examine all labels in the cereal aisle. They can be very tricky. Also, remember that honey, too, is considered as sugar. Totally omit white starches from your diet. They are nothing but empty calories. This includes white bread, pasta, and rice. Buy the whole grain version, instead, and enjoy in moderation. Legumes and beans are healthy for you, but they are high in carbohydrates. You can have them occasionally, just make sure you keep it within your daily 25 carb gram count. Alcohols tend to be empty calories, but certain spirits will be better for you than others. Beer is filled with carbs and should be off your keto diet. The expression, beer belly, exists for a reason. Enjoy a glass of wine, instead. Of course, there are variances in different types of wine. Dry wines contain a minimum amount of sugar, while sweet dessert wines contain much more. Pure alcohols such as whiskey and vodka are carb-free, but they do contain calories, so have a care. Mixing alcohol for fancy cocktails usually creates a haven for sugar, so avoid those. Wine coolers may be a tasty treat, but in reality, they are just sugary sodas with some added alcohol. They should definitely not be on your keto diet at any time. 7. Keto diet for rapid weight loss. Many people confuse the ketogenic diet with low-carb diets or paleo diets. However, there are considerable differences of which you should be aware. Keto v. low-carb. A low-carb diet can be anything it wants to be, as long as it is low in carbohydrates. And low is rarely defined. On a low-carb diet, you simply make random food choices that curb your carb intake arbitrarily. Since there is no real number, you might still be consuming too many carbs. Most importantly, what the low-carb diet lacks is that all-critical ketonic state that turns carbs into fats and provides your body with a new and effective source of fuel. This can leave you very hungry and tired. The ketogenic diet has a specific ratio of carbs to fats to protein. This manipulation is critical, and it's why a low-carb diet won't work as well, if at all. Keto v. Paleo. The paleo is also a low-carb type diet. It is based on the assumption that eating the way our cavemen ancestors did, i.e., meat and no carbs, sugars, or grains, is the healthiest type of diet. There are problems with this reasoning. First, our ancestors never experienced the kind of diseases that we face. The ketogenic diet is specifically a healing diet that is meant to benefit the body in many ways and help prevent diseases. The paleo diet does not do that. Also, the paleo diet is based on eating meat instead of manipulating the ratio of fats, carbohydrates, and protein to achieve a ketonic state that uses fat as fuel. Ketogenic diet. Basically, ketogenic is low carb, but it is much more. There is a reason the ketogenic diet has become so popular. It helps improve your overall well-being in addition to helping you lose weight. You have more energy during the day, and you feel sated and full, thereby reducing the cravings for unhealthy snacks. In essence, you are eating less, but better. That's what makes the keto diet so unique and successful. The ketogenic diet is not a magic pill made up by some gurus. Countless studies and testimonials are able to back the effectiveness of this diet. It is a scientifically proven method that balances your body's fat intake to help achieve optimal weight loss. By using fat instead of sugar as your primary source of energy, the keto diet induces a state of ketosis, which is achieved when your body stops receiving carbohydrates to turn in glucose. The fewer carbohydrates you consume, the more you force your body to burn fat for energy instead of storing it. This is why it is possible to lose weight so quickly on the keto diet. It counts carbohydrates instead of calories. Using fats as an additional energy source is what ketosis is all about. It is a natural state that helped our hunter-gatherer ancestors survive in early days. They feasted on low-carb foods when they could, and fasted when food was scarce. Fat was stored and converted into energy during the scarce times. The ketogenic state is a natural human state, which makes the ketogenic diet so powerful and successful. In addition to the benefits of the keto diet, most people simply enjoy the way it makes them feel better. Weight loss results on the keto diet differ among individuals, depending on their specific body composition. But weight loss has been the consistent result of people who've been on the keto diet. The keto diet is known as the best weight loss diet, as well as the healthiest. A 2017 study divided CrossFit training subjects into two groups, with both groups following the physical training, but only one group combined the ketogenic diet with the training. The results showed that those on the keto diet decreased their fat mass and weight far more than the other group. The keto diet group showed an average of 3.5 kilo weight loss, 2.6% of body fat, and 2.83 kilos in fat mass, while the other group lost no weight, body fat or fat mass. Both groups showed similar athletic performance ability. A 2012 study divided overweight children and adolescents into two groups. One was put on a keto diet, the other on a low-calorie diet. As in other keto studies, the children on the keto diet decreased their weight, fat mass, and lowered their insulin levels considerably more than the low-calorie group. Besides more rapid weight loss, a decided advantage of the keto diet over a low-calorie diet is that people actually stick to the keto diet. A low-calorie diet will help you lose weight, but you may be constantly feeling hungry and deprived. That is the main reason most diets fail. Hunger and deprivation are not a part of the ketogenic lifestyle. Ketosis explained. As we have stated earlier, the keto diet isn't magic. It is proven science. Ketosis is a natural occurrence that happens when you don't feed your body enough carbohydrates and it is forced to look for energy elsewhere. You have undoubtedly experienced ketosis when you've missed a meal or have exhausted your body with rigorous exercise. Whenever these things happen, your body helps you out by raising its level of ketones. However, most people eat enough sugar and carbs to keep ketosis from happening. We love our sugar and carbs, no matter how bad they are for us, and our bodies will happily use them as fuel. And since our bodies want to help us out, it turns any excess glucose into fat and stores it for future use. Stored fat translated into those ridiculous belly fat that you never want. The more you restrict your carbohydrate consumption, the more your body will produce ketones. It really has no other options. When we restrict the amount of carbohydrates that we eat, our body will still provide us with energy, but it must turn to another source. And that alternate source is fat that was so thoughtfully stored for emergencies. The result is a state of ketosis. It happens when our body breaks down the fat into fatty acids and glycerol. Researchers have discovered most of what they know about ketosis from people who fast, thereby depriving them of all sources of energy. After 2 days of fasting, the body is starting to produce ketones as it breaks down the available protein and begins to use stored fat for fuel. Ketosis is the natural process the body goes through when deprived of other sources of energy. Obviously, going on a ketogenic diet is healthier than fasting. Ketogenic should become a lifestyle, not a quick weight loss method. One of the reasons it is so beneficial is that ketones offer protection against diseases and damages that can affect the body. As mentioned before, keto diet is an excellent tool to prevent many diseases and maintain health and strength longer. Planning your keto meals will depend largely on your goals. Are you trying to lose weight, or are you on the keto diet to alleviate the symptoms of some disease? The average keto diet will consist of 4 meals per day, with a total of 100 grams of protein, 25 to 50 grams of carbohydrates, and 140 to 160 grams of fat. This can, of course, be adjusted to your personal needs. For example, if you are on a keto diet to improve cognitive functions, you may want to raise your fat intake to 90 grams a day for optimal results. Benefits of intermittent fasting on keto. The science behind the ketogenic diet is that the body burns fat when deprived of other sources of fuel. Intermittent fasting is a deliberate deprivation of food and takes the concept a step further. We're not talking long-term fasting. Intermittent fasting while on a keto diet meant having 2 meals a day or fasting for 1 day a week. The fasting time gives the body a chance to rest and rid itself of toxins. It provides an extra boost to the weight loss benefits of keto and is a great way to jumpstart the diet. For weight loss, the keto diet, combined with intermittent fasting, will help you reach your goal faster and easier. 8. Getting started on the keto diet. You're ready for a new and improved you. Congratulations! There are so many wonderful benefits to the ketogenic diet, you can expect many positive changes, both physical and mental. So, let's not delay and get the journey started. Clear your pantry. We're sure you have plenty of willpower, but there is no need to confront a kitchen filled with tempting sugars and carbohydrates. Make a clean sweep and pack the offending items in a box. Then donate the loot to a needy neighbor or a soup kitchen. They will appreciate your gesture, and you are on your way to a keto lifestyle. If you have family, try to get them involved. If they refuse to refrain from eating carbs and sugar, at least insist they do so away from home. It's a fair request. Weigh yourself. The keto diet does not require you to live by the tyranny of the scale. As a matter of fact, as you build up healthy muscles, you might notice a slight initial gain. That's great, so don't worry. You should, however, have an idea of what your starting point is. If you opted for the keto diet solely to lose weight, you'll be able to track your progress. But don't become a slave to the scale. The occasional weigh-in, perhaps once a week, is enough. What about your favorite meals? Perhaps the very thought of giving up your favorite foods has prevented you from getting started on the keto way of life. Relax. The truth is, for every dish that you love and can't live without, yes, that includes cheesecake and mashed potatoes, you can easily find a low-carb substitute that is just as tasty. First, let's consider items at your market labeled low-carbohydrate. Labels are frustratingly deceiving, and you'd have to be a nutritional expert to understand them. All too frequently, off-the-shelf low-carb products have simply substituted sugar for carbs, so don't fall for that bit of deceit. You need to learn to read labels with the diligence that you'd read your wealthy uncle's will, but your best bet is to stay away from these products and simply find healthier substitutes. The same goes for anything labeled low-fat, which inevitably means added sugars. Craving a taco? Use a lettuce wrap instead of a taco shell. Do you want rice or mashed potatoes? Grate or rice a cauliflower, and you won't be able to tell the difference. Can't give up your favorite pasta dish? Turn a zucchini into zoodles by slicing it or using a spiral cutter and enjoy your pasta. You absolutely have to have your favorite dessert? On the keto diet, you can just bake with almond flour and use unsweetened applesauce and or avocado to create some sweet smoothness. Learn about coconut oil, which can be used as a butter substitute in sautéing, frying, and baking. Coconut oil has incredible health benefits, especially for type 2 diabetics. On the keto diet, you'll be able to enjoy all your favorite meals, only better. Always stay hydrated. The keto diet tends to lower your insulin level, so your kidneys may be excreting more liquid than usual. Be sure to drink plenty of water. Condiments can be the enemy. Don't assume condiments don't count on a diet. On the keto diet, they most certainly do. Ketchup is filled with sugar. Not all salad dressings are equal. Read the label, and never opt for the fat-free version. They have merely substituted sugar for fat. Ordering salads when eating out is one of your best options, but beware of the dressing that the restaurant serves. Either ask about the ingredients, or better, bring your own salad dressing. Don't hesitate to do that, even in a posh eatery where the maitre d' might become spastic at the sight of you pulling salad dressing out of your bag. Keep track of your ketone level. It's especially important to remain aware of how your body is responding to the keto diet at the start of the diet. You can do so by doing a simple urine test. You can also purchase a blood ketone meter. It is recommended to perform the test early in the morning. Friends and family can be annoying, bless their hearts, those nearest and dearest to you may not always understand what you are doing. When eating as a group, they may put subtle pressure on you to just try a bite, or one slice of cake won't kill you. Or worse, but I cooked it especially for you. It will take resolve to stick to your diet. It may help to fill up on keto-friendly snacks before you sit down and eat. Enjoy some nuts, an avocado, or just a leg of chicken before you eat, and you will be less tempted. Celebrate. Celebratory occasions, especially if you're the guest of honor, can be a huge hurdle. When the gang at the office or your parents enter a room with a cake yelling, "Surprise!" on your birthday, it's hard to refuse. So, try being a bit sneaky, instead. By all means gush over the offering. You are expected to do that. You can even help cut slices. Then, discover a sudden and irresistible urge for coffee, which you verbalize loudly and clearly. Gently remove yourself from the center of activity to get coffee for yourself and anyone else. By the time anyone notices, hopefully they've missed the fact that you haven't eaten anything. Traveling. Traveling while on the keto diet can be a challenge, so be prepared. Pack a personal blender with some avocados and bananas for a few quick and healthful smoothies. Pack some anchovies or tuna for protein. Eating out. Eating out isn't as difficult as you may think. Even fast food places have salads, these days. In any restaurant, stick to meat and vegetables and forego the potatoes and noodles. You can even navigate the tricky maze in a Chinese restaurant. While abstaining from rice, you can enjoy the following: clear soups, steamed fish with vegetables, egg foo young, stir-fried dishes, mu shu without the wrappers are just a few suggestions. Ask your server if your meal can be prepared without cornstarch, which is frequently used as a thickener. Even if you end up in a fast food place that doesn't have salad, simply toss the buns from your burger and just eat the meat. You can do the same at a friend's house or at a barbecue. Exercise. The keto diet will build muscle mass and give you added energy. Don't forget to incorporate exercise into your daily routine. It can be as simple as walking more, taking the stairs, or joining a gym. How long should you stay on a ketogenic diet? The amount of time spent on the diet can vary and should be discussed with your doctor. Many people who use the ketogenic diet for weight loss remain on the diet for several weeks, until they have achieved a goal, then they turn to a paleo diet or other maintenance eating. You do not want to lose weight only to return to your old eating habits. If you are on the ketogenic diet for medical or therapeutic reasons, check with your doctor to ascertain if you should remain on the diet for a longer period of time. 9 Keto Recipes. You can take your favorite recipes and turn them keto. Below are a few recipes to show you how easy it is. It might be an excellent idea to buy a keto cookbook for your kitchen. Two of the most important keto recipes are the simple cauliflower rice and zoodles. They couldn't be easier to prepare. People can get frustrated on the keto diet when they crave pasta and rice. These two recipes definitely satisfy those cravings, they taste just like the real thing. The zoodles can be used for any pasta dish. Invest in a calorie counter, as you will need it. Omelette muffins, make plenty of these ahead of time. They'll go fast. Ingredients: 1 tablespoon butter, 10 eggs, salt and pepper to taste, 1/2 cup diced ham, 1/4 cup drained spinach, 1/4 cup diced onion, 1/4 cup chopped red bell pepper, 1/4 cup shredded pepper jack cheese. Directions: preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Coat a muffin pan with non-stick spray. Whisk the eggs, then stir in the remaining ingredients. Fill the muffin pan with the mixture, bake for 25 minutes. Nutritional facts: calories 155, carb 2 grams, fat 10 grams, protein 12.5 grams. Breakfast casserole: this is a delicious casserole everyone can enjoy. It will leave you satisfied until lunch. Ingredients: 10 eggs, 1/4 cup whipping cream, 1 cup ricotta cheese, 1 diced onion, salt and pepper to taste, 1 package thawed frozen spinach, 1 cup sliced mushrooms, 1 lb crumbled sausage meat. Directions: preheat oven to 350 degrees. Whisk the eggs, whipping cream, ricotta cheese and onion well, season with salt and pepper. Add the spinach, mushrooms, and crumbled sausage. Bake for 30 minutes. Keto pancakes: serve these pancakes with butter and sugar-free syrup or with berries. Ingredients: 1/4 cup almond flour, 2 tablespoons honey, dash of salt, 1 teaspoon baking powder, 1 teaspoon cinnamon, 6 beaten eggs, 1/4 cup plain Greek yogurt, 3 tablespoons melted butter, 1 teaspoon lemon extract. Directions: stir the flour, baking powder, and cinnamon in a bowl. Combine the eggs, honey, yogurt, lemon extract, and butter in another bowl. Slowly stir the egg mixture into the flour mixture. Use 2 tablespoons of batter and drop on a hot griddle. Cook for 4 minutes, then flip and cook for another 2 minutes. Continue until all batter has been used. Nutritional information: 413 calories, 34 grams fat, 18.4 grams carbohydrates, 16.3 grams protein. Apple red cabbage. Cabbage is a great vegetable to have on keto. This red cabbage side dish is yummy. Ingredients: 8 slices of bacon, cut into pieces, 1 large diced onion, 1 peeled and sliced apple, 2 cup chicken broth, 3 tablespoons red cider vinegar, 2 tablespoons coconut palm sugar or sugar substitute, such as Splenda, 1 teaspoon. Ground cloves, 1/2 teaspoon. Allspice, 1/2 teaspoon. Nutmeg, salt and pepper to taste, 1 shredded red cabbage. Directions: fry the bacon in a skillet until crispy. Add the onion and sauté for 5 to 6 minutes. Stir in the broth, sugar, vinegar, spices, salt and pepper. Add the cabbage and cook on low for 45 minutes. Nutrition facts: 160 calories, 7.8 grams fat, 16 grams carbohydrates, 4 grams protein. Cinnamon granola. Store-bought granola usually has a high sugar content. Try this instead. Ingredients: 1 cup chopped walnuts, 1/2 cup shredded coconuts, 1/4 cup sliced almonds, 2 tablespoons sunflower seeds, 1/2 teaspoon cinnamon, 1 tablespoon coconut palm sugar, 1 tablespoon melted butter. Directions: preheat the oven to 375 degrees. Combine the walnuts, shredded coconut, sliced almonds, and sunflower seeds. Add cinnamon and coconut palm sugar and stir into the nut mixture. Spread the mixture in a single layer on a baking sheet. Drizzle with the melted butter. Bake for 20 minutes. Nutrition facts: 180 calories, 19 grams fat, 4.1 grams carbohydrates, 4 grams protein. Herbed omelet with smoked salmon. You can enjoy this omelet anytime, but a breakfast of protein and fatty acids gets the day started right. Ingredients: 2 tablespoons butter, 2 beaten eggs, 1 teaspoon tarragon, 1 teaspoon Thyme, salt and pepper to taste, 1 tablespoon butter, 2 tablespoons chopped onions, 4 very thin tomato slices, 2 smoked salmon sliced, 1 teaspoon capers. Directions: whisk the eggs and add the tarragon, thyme, salt, and pepper. Melt the butter in a skillet and add the beaten eggs and chopped onions. Cook for 3 to 4 minutes, until the eggs begin to set. Transfer the omelet to a plate and top with the tomato and salmon slices. Sprinkle with capers. Nutrition facts: calories, 239, fat 15 grams, carbohydrates 4 grams, protein 22 grams. Cheeseburger salad: this is your favorite cheeseburger without the bun. Ingredients: 1 lb. Ground beef, salt and pepper to taste, 3 cups chopped lettuce, 1 small diced onion, 1 sliced tomato, 1 quarter cup shredded cheddar cheese, 4 tablespoons oil and vinegar dressing. Directions: fry the ground beef in a skillet for 4 minutes. Add the onion and cook for another 5 minutes. Place the beef and onions in a bowl and add the remaining ingredients, except the dressing. Coat with the salad dressing. Nutrition facts: calories 290, fat 14 grams, carbohydrates 6, protein 25 grams. Cauliflower rice: this very simple recipe is for basic rice. You can dress it up with vegetables, spices, or stir-fry it. Use this anytime you need rice as a side dish or in a recipe. Ingredients: 1 cauliflower head. Directions: chop the cauliflower into florets. Place the florets in a food processor and pulse until you have a rice-like consistency. Cook the rice in a pan of salted water for 5 minutes. Nutritional facts: calories 21, carbohydrates 5, fat 0, protein 0. Zoodles: these zoodles made from zucchini taste like noodles. A spiralizer is the easiest way to create zoodles, but you can also use a mandolin. Zoodles get soggy very easily, so do not cook for more than 1 minute. Season with butter or shredded cheese. Ingredients: 1 zucchini. Directions: use a spiralizer to create pasta strands. Bring a pot of salted water to boil and cook the zoodles for 1 minute. Bacon-wrapped chicken: a very decadent and delicious way to enjoy chicken. Ingredients: 2 pounds boneless and skinless chicken breast, 2 cups chopped spinach, 1 cup sliced mushrooms, 1 cup cream cheese, 1/2 cup cottage cheese, salt and pepper to taste, 12 slices bacon. Directions: preheat the oven to 375 degrees, combine the spinach, mushroom, cream cheese and cottage cheese in a bowl. Season the mixture with salt and pepper. Use a mallet to flatten the chicken pieces to a 1/2 inch thickness. Use a sharp knife to cut pockets in one end. Spoon the mixture into the pockets. Wrap 2 bacon slices around each chicken piece. Brown the wrapped chicken in a skillet 5 minutes each side. Place the chicken pieces in a baking dish. Bake the chicken for 45 minutes. The bacon should be crispy and the chicken done. Nutrition facts: calories 390, fat 22 grams, carbs 3.9 grams, protein 41 grams. Cobb salad: this salad is very high in protein. Enjoy. Ingredients for dressing: 1 tablespoon olive oil, 1 tablespoon white vinegar, 1 teaspoon Dijon mustard, 2 tablespoons diced onion, salt and pepper to taste. Ingredients for Cobb salad: 3/4 cup cubed cooked chicken, 1/2 cup diced tomatoes, 1/2 cup blue cheese, 2 tablespoons blue cheese, 1 sliced hard-boiled egg, 2 cups chopped greens, 1 sliced avocado, 4 cooked and sliced bacon slices. Directions: arrange the greens on a plate, arrange rows of chicken, diced tomatoes, blue cheese, egg slices, avocado slices and bacon pieces on top of the greens. Combine all dressing ingredients. Drizzle the dressing over the salad. Nutrition facts: calories 295, fat 11 grams, carbs 4 grams, protein 22 grams. Slow cooker pot roast: this pot roast is prepared without potatoes or carrots. If you add them, adjust the carbs accordingly. Ingredients: 2 lb. Chuck roast, salt and pepper to taste, 1 tablespoon olive oil, 2 minced garlic cloves, 1 chopped onion, 2 1/2 cup beef broth, 1/2 cup dry red wine. Directions: season the roast with salt and pepper. Salt and pepper the roast. Heat the olive oil in a skillet and brown the roast on all sides. Place the roast and remaining ingredients in the slow cooker. Stir the ingredients to combine. Cook on low for 6 hours. Nutrition facts: calories 242, fat 12 grams, carbs 9.8 grams, protein 21 grams. Spinach and sausage soup. This soup is loaded with flavor while remaining very low in carbs. Ingredients: 1 lb. Spicy crumbled Italian sausage, 1 tablespoon olive oil, 1 chopped onion, 2 sliced carrots, 1 minced garlic clove, 2 tablespoons red wine vinegar, 1/2 teaspoon oregano, dash of hot sauce, 4 cups chicken broth, 1/2 cup whipping cream, 2 cups baby spinach, salt and pepper to taste. Directions: heat the olive oil in a skillet and sauté the crumbled sausage for 5 minutes, until it is no longer pink. Transfer the sausage to a plate and drain on a paper towel. Sauté the onion, garlic, and carrot in the same pan. Deglaze the pan with the red wine vinegar. Add the chicken stock, whipping cream, oregano and hot sauce and stir well. Season with salt and pepper. Simmer the soup for 5 minutes. Transfer the sausage back into the pan and stir in the spinach. Cook for 1 minute to allow the spinach to wilt. Nutrition facts: calories 137, fat 7.8 grams, carbs 2 grams, protein 11 grams. Tandoori chicken. Tandoori chicken is all about the spice marinade. Serve it with some cauliflower rice. Ingredients: 2 pounds chicken thighs. Ingredients for marinade: 1 cup plain yogurt, 2 teaspoon lemon juice, salt and pepper to taste, 2 tablespoons olive oil, 2 minced garlic cloves, 1 teaspoon chili powder, 1 teaspoon grated fresh ginger, 1 teaspoon garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon cumin. Directions: with a sharp knife, cut several slits into the chicken thighs. Season the chicken with salt and pepper and drizzle with the lemon juice. Combine the remaining ingredients in a large bowl. Place the chicken in the bowl and coat thoroughly. Refrigerate up to 24 hours. The longer you marinate, the more flavor is absorbed. Preheat the oven to 375 degrees. Line a baking sheet with aluminum foil and layer the chicken on top. Bake for about 45 to 50 minutes, until the skin is nice and crispy. Nutrition facts: calories 145, fat 5.8 grams, carbs 2.3 grams, protein 17 grams. Curried lamb filled with exotic spices. This curry dish is perfect with keto rice. Ingredients: 2 pounds lamb meat, 1 tablespoon olive oil, 1 diced onion, 3 minced garlic cloves, 1/2 teaspoon grated ginger, 1/2 to turmeric, 1/2 teaspoon curry powder, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala, 2 cups beef stock, 1 cup plain Greek yogurt, 1 teaspoon lemon juice. Directions: cut the lamb meat into small pieces, sauté the onion in the olive oil for 5 minutes, then add the garlic, ginger, turmeric, curry powder and garam masala. Stir for another 5 minutes. Add the meat and brown it for 10 minutes. Pour in the beef stock and simmer for 40 minutes. Remove from heat and stir in the yogurt and lemon juice. Nutrition facts: calories 329, fat 17 grams, carbs 9.1 grams, protein 36 grams. Cheddar biscuits. These tasty biscuits are great anytime. They freeze well, so keep them handy. Ingredients: 2 cups almond flour, 1 cup shredded cheddar cheese, 1 cup coconut oil, 1 cup cream cheese, 3 eggs, 2 teaspoon baking powder, 1 teaspoon baking soda, dash of salt. Directions: preheat oven to 325 degrees. Cover a baking sheet with aluminum foil. Place the flour and the cheese in a food processor and pulse to a grainy consistency. Add the baking powder and baking soda. Heat the cream cheese and coconut oil in a small pan and warm until they melt. Stir to a creamy smoothness. Whisk the eggs and add the salt. Stir the flour mixture into the egg mixture and stir until a dough forms. Use a tablespoon to drop the dough onto the baking sheet. Bake for 25 minutes. Allow the biscuits to cool for slicing. Nutrition facts: calories 106, fat 11.1 grams, carbs 2 grams, protein 3.9 grams. Conclusion. Congratulations. You've mastered the ketogenic diet. You've lost weight, feel better, look fabulous, and are enjoying an abundance of energy. You've put a lot of effort into improving your health, so what happens when you've reached your goal and it's time to abandon the keto diet? It's a hard fact that maintaining your weight loss can actually be more difficult than losing that weight in the first place. Returning to your old, bad eating habits may be all too tempting. In addition, when you discontinue the keto diet, your metabolism is likely to slow down, making weight maintenance more difficult. You certainly don't want to lose momentum and return to the unhealthy, all-American, sugar and carbohydrate swamp, with your lost weight returning. The options below are undoubtedly best at maintaining your current state of health. Consider your options before you stop the keto diet. Have a plan in place and execute it. Since the keto diet provides you with many options, it will be easier to adjust to a maintenance style. Continue keto. Continue on the keto diet that has been successful for you, but consume more food. Not different, high-carb foods, but the same foods you ate on the diet, in somewhat larger quantities. You'll be eating more calories. This will allow you to eat more protein and fats, but keep the carbohydrate level low. This can be a hit-and-miss process, simply add more calories to your diet and see how your body reacts and adjust accordingly. This option ensures that carbohydrates are no longer running your life, as you won't suffer from the cravings you might have had when you started the keto diet. Shift from losing weight to gaining muscles. With the increasing energy you enjoy on the keto diet, you may wish to focus on improving your muscle tone. Many athletes are fans of the keto diet. This means retaining your low body fat but adding muscle and definition. Strong muscles help strengthen bone density and keep you strong as you age. The best way to gain strong muscles is to consume more calories in the form of lean proteins. This option is difficult to maintain unless to include a resistance training exercise program. Remain on low carb but not on keto. When you use the keto diet to lose weight, your carbohydrate restrictions are fairly strict. You can still maintain your weight with a low-carb diet, but not as rigid as keto. There are many healthy beans and legumes you can enjoy by adding a few more carbs to your diet. How much more carbs is very individual, because every body is different. Add a few cups of beans, lentils, or another serving of carrots to your diet each week and see how your body reacts. If you continue to maintain your goal weight, you're on the right track. Add 10 grams of carbohydrates a week until you are satisfied with the results. The advantage of this option is that it allows you to eat good, healthy foods that were off limits on the keto diet. Having a greater variety of foods from which to choose will make it easier to maintain your weight. If you find yourself gaining weight, simply cut down on the added carbs just a bit. Use intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting gives you additional options. Remember that fasting forces your body to burn fat. Here are some ways you can fast intermittently. 1. Eat what you want for 5 days, then fast for 2 days. 2. Eat 2 meals a day instead of 3, providing for a longer period where you are not consuming food. When you begin to embrace keto, you will be enjoying all the benefits of healthy eating. By continuing to consume fewer carbohydrates as a lifestyle, your body will remain sleek and strong. You will also be providing it with ammunition to ward off many chronic diseases.